My name is Skylar Smith, and today we're going to talk about the PV monitoring package available from Apogee Instruments. And this is a list of everything included in the package. Each of these sensors is available separately for your own application. We designed this to go with an SMA cluster controller, so each of these are compatible with that. But if for your application you only need certain ones, feel free to contact us for availability on that. So the package includes the SP214 solar radiation sensor, the ST150 air temperature sensor, the TS100 fan aspirated shield, and then the CS240 backup panel temperature sensor. And then the smaller things are accessories to help with the installation of those. The SP214 measures your solar radiation in watts per meter squared. And it comes with a standard 5-meter cable. It is a silicon cell detector, but we calibrate it to match those higher end black body thermopile secondary standards. And so I have a link here for the traceability. You can find that same link in the comments below. But what we mean by calibrating to those secondary standards is that our spectra response is from 360 to 1120 nanometers for the SP214. But we calibrate it to match those high-end secondary standards that have a range of 285 to 2800 nanometers. So that means on a clear sky, our SP214 is going to read the same as those high-end secondary standards. The ST150 ambient air temperature sensor, it's a Class A PRT, IP67 rated, comes standard 5-meter cable, and it does meet that IEC standard for air temperature accuracy. Now you can just put that in a GILL shield, or we recommend putting it into our active radiation shield, our TS100. And you can see in this picture over here on this cross section how the ST150 would just slide right in there. So the idea behind this is it's got a fan in there to circulate the air so you're getting the highest accurate air temperature possible. It comes with that long rated fan, comes with 5-meter standard. This particular 24-volt step-down converter, again, is designed for that SMA cluster controller that is powered with 24 volts to step that down to the 12 volts needed to run the fan. Now, as far as that argument between GILL shield and active radiation shield, we did some testing on our roofs to show the difference. And you can see the blue across the top here is your passive radiation shield, your GILL shield right there. And then the red is our TS100 active radiation shield. So if your goal is to meet that IEC 61724-1 specification, the uncertainty says it has to be plus or minus 1 degree C. And that's in gray on our graph here. And each of these blue dots and red dots are 15-minute averages for measurements. So you can see when the sun comes out and gets between 5 and 600 watts per meter squared, that we are actually outside of that range with a GILL shield, that we're outside that 1 degree C accuracy. So if you want to stay within that particular specification, you really need some sort of active shield. That's why we recommend the TS100. CS240 backup panel temperature sensor, Class A PRT, highly accurate, comes in your standard cable lengths 15 and 50 meters in length, and then it also includes that kapton tape for mounting. So to recap, our PV100 monitoring package does include everything on this list here. The 214, the solar mounting bracket with leveling plate, the air temperature sensor, the fan aspirated shield, the step down converter, and then the backup panel temperature sensor with that kapton tape. So please feel free to contact us by email, by phone for price and availability. We'll love to get you a quote on that. Thank you so much for watching. Any questions, feel free to email us, give us a call, and don't forget to click below to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.